Next, now we are going to see about your hydraulic turbines. And this hydraulic turbines, your previously your axial flow pump and your axial centrifugal pump and your axial flow compressor, centrifugal compressor, all comes under the category of power absorbing machines. And this hydraulic turbines or turbines, which will be comes under the category of your power developing machines. That is, it is used to generate the electrical energy. And again, this will be having two main categories, as we previously seen, the impulse and reaction turbine. And what does this impulse mean? Where the pressure is just a constant pressure throughout the operation. Whereas in the case of a reaction turbine, the operation of the fluid while the turbine will be operating, it will be just having the variable pressure, and that will be comes under the reaction turbine category. Okay, the first we are going to see about the Pelton wheel turbine, which will be the application name of a impulse turbine, that is your constant pressure turbine. This is a laboratory model of a Pelton wheel turbine in the fluid mechanics lab. You can see in your university or in your colleges also, you can see your this Pelton wheel application of the lab model. Okay, here you can see this Pelton wheel. Why it is called as a Pelton wheel turbine means it is named after the inventor, that is Pelton, who is the inventor of this particular machine. And again, this Pelton wheel turbine having the basic of four important categorization of your this component. And the first one will be the nozzle and flow regulating arrangement. Okay, you can see this will be the operation of your Pelton wheel turbine. First, you can see this Pelton wheel turbine basically having this this one, it will be called as a penstock. It will be called as a penstock. What is this penstock means? This penstock will be thus allowing the water to flow from a higher elevation to the lower elevation. That means here you can see this turbine needs the fluid energy to create your electrical energy by means of creating a mechanical. In this lab model, this will be a penstock, and again actually this penstock will be connected or will be just drawn from the higher elevation where your fluid will be available. For example, here you will be having a dam where the water will be just stored from the higher elevation, and from the dam the penstock will be connected, and by means of operating the gates you will be just sending the fluid with the higher energy. While the fluid with the higher energy flowing towards the penstock, here at the end you will be having a flow regulating devices. That is nothing but your nozzle and the spear arrangement. Here you will be having a needle arrangement where it will be just by moving this needle front and towards to and fro motion, you will be just adjusting the nozzle. While you are adjusting this nozzle, you can just control the kinetic energy or the velocity at which this will be striking this bucket. This center part, which will be called as a bucket or a runner, where it is just a rotary wheel where your blades will be fixed. Since this blades will be at the shape of a bucket, it will be called as a bucket. Usually it is called as a runner. And now how this Pelton will operate means this fluid will be just flowing towards your penstock. And this penstock fluid will be just arranged, or fluid will be controlled by means of operation of this nozzle arrangement. And this fluid will be striking towards your runner blade. And this rotation of the runner blade will be connected towards the shaft. And that shaft, the mechanical energy will be just moved, or just mechanical energy will be transformed to the electrical energy by means of a generator. You can see the movement of the spear or the nozzle arrangement, which will be increasing and decreasing the flow of the fluid so that the speed of the output or the output can be controlled by means of this nozzle and speed regulating device. Okay, and again, while discussing with this Pelton wheel turbine, you have to just, it is important to know about the braking jet. Okay, what is this braking jet means? This center runner blade, which will be rotating at the higher speed, it having a more inertia. It is a heavy blade because initially to move the blade it needs more energy, so that it will be just initially rotating by means of the fluid energy. It will be initially rotating. And whenever we just want to shut down the turbine or to stop the turbine, whenever the water is stopped also, this turbine will be, or this runner blade will be, continues to rotate after the water has been stopped also. So that the braking jet is needed to brake the, or to stop or shut down the turbine as per the user application or the user needed. So that, what is this braking jet means? A small nozzle arrangement similar to your penstock. It will be just arranged from your penstock. That means your water flow will be allowed by means of the braking jet in the opposite direction. Initially, this penstock will be just allowed the liquid or the fluid with the higher energy towards this nozzle, so that it will be rotating in this direction. And what is this braking jet means? It is to stop the operation of your Pelton wheel turbine. In the opposite direction, you will allow the small volume of fluid to flow in the opposite direction, so that it can stop it immediately or gradually as per the user need to just stop or shut down your turbine. Okay, this is all about your Pelton wheel turbine. And next one will be the Francis turbine. Here this turbine will be comes under the reaction turbine. Unless you're here you can see this Pelton wheel turbine, it will be just this outer casing, this outer casing which will be available in the outside. Okay, this this casing, it is not a closed type. It is just operate on atmospheric pressure. The pressure outside and the pressure inside this casing also same. But why this casing is used means to just reducing or just stopping or preventing the splashing of liquids to flow away from your while your turbine will be operating. So this pressure will be both outside and inside will be same. And here in the case of your Francis turbine, you can see the initial parts. You can see the first one, you will be having the outer casing, and again you will be having a rotary impeller, and over the impeller you will be having this guide vane. And what this guide vane means, the similar to your diffuser, it will be just used to guide the water towards your impeller. The water will be just coming towards this entry point and it flows inside, and this guide blades guide the water to flow towards the center of your impeller or your runner vane. While this water or fluid entering, this guide vane makes the water to flow towards the center runner vane, so that the energy will be just transferred towards your shaft. And again in this case, you can see while the water will be moving from guide vane towards your diffuser, sorry, towards your runner vane, it increases the pressure. The fluid will be flowing towards all the area, or it will just flow inside towards all throughout your blade, and finally it exits towards the center point. In this center point, you will be having, in this center point, you will be having the connection of your draft tube. Okay, what is this draft tube means? This draft tube will be just having the variable geometry. That means it will be having increase of geometry from inlet towards your outlet. Why this draft tube is needed means, here this turbine comes under the reaction turbine. While the liquid enters towards the exit, it will be increases the pressure. The output pressure will be very much high compared to your Pelton wheel. Here you can see in the case of your Pelton wheel turbine, your water will be strikes and it just flows. It just falls towards the ground. Only sink is needed. The water will be strikes and it will just flow. There will not be no increase in pressure. As we seen in the case of your power producing machine, the output will be the fluid with the lower energy. And here, since it will be operating in the open flow type and the atmospheric pressure outside and inside is same, the water will be just, after striking, the water loses its energy and it just flows towards the tail race or down sink. And here in the case, why this draft tube is needed means, while the water will be entering, the pressure will be further increased towards while you are running a runner blade rotating, and it just exits towards your draft tube. And this draft tube reduces the kinetic energy and the pressure of your the kinetic energy of the fluid which will be coming outside your turbine, so that this outlet is not affected, the outlet atmosphere or outlet area is not affected by means of the higher pressure of the outlet of your Francis turbine. Here, this Francis turbine is named after your James P. Francis, who invented this kind of your Francis turbine. Here you can see this animation will be showing. This center one will be the guide vanes, and over that outer area will be having a spiral casing. The liquid will be entering towards the spiral casing, and it flows towards the guide vanes, and it reaches the center blade. And the down part, you will be having the draft tube. So now you can see the top view. The fluid will be entering towards the spiral casing. The guide vane guides the fluid towards the center of your runner blade. And this center runner blade, while it will be rotating, you can see the shaft, which will be connected. And this shaft will be giving the output to the electrical generator. That means the input will be the fluid energy, and it flows towards the guide blades, towards the center runner vane. And while this runner vane rotating, and the fluid enters towards the runner vane and finally exits towards the draft tube. And while this runner vane will be rotating, it will be just giving the output mechanical energy, so that your turbine will just thus your input energy conversion process. Again, the next turbine will be called as a Kaplan turbine. And here this turbine will be used for the smaller heads compared to your Francis turbine and Pelton wheel turbine. Here you will be having the center shaft. And this shaft will be connected towards your propeller type blades. Here the Kaplan turbine is also called as a propeller turbine. The simple difference is here the gate is there. In this case of this Kaplan turbine, this gate or this guide vanes or guide blades can be adjustable. The angle of this guide blade can be adjustable to make the water flow towards the desired direction to get the output as much of desired. So this Kaplan turbine, it will be used for smaller heads. And here the advantage or the difference between this Francis turbine and this Kaplan turbine is here the guide vanes. In the case of your Francis turbine, this guide vanes and this guide vanes, the angle cannot be varied. But in the case of your Kaplan turbine, you will be just varying your angle of these blades can be varied to allow the fluid flow in the different proportion inside your Kaplan turbine. And here, this Kaplan turbine is invented by means of Victor Kaplan in the year of, the year of 1913 and 1922. Here, it will be giving the 90% of better efficiency compared to your Francis turbine. Okay, but here you can see this way. You can see the guide blades, and again your flow, your water inlet flow will be there, and this guide blades angle can be adjusted so that the flow of water can be varied and it flows towards your runner blade. Okay, basically this Kaplan type, both there are two varieties. In one varieties or one type, you will be adjusting only the guide blades to allow the flow in the different mark. But in the case, there is another classification there, that is in the another case your runner blade angles can also be varied, so it can be adjusted in the double manner, both your inlet guide blades and again your propeller or runner blades angle can also be varied to achieve the various kind of efficiency. Okay, here you can see this animation of your the rotation of your runner blade, your water flows and water exits towards your draft tube. Okay, and this Kaplan turbine or the Francis turbine and your Pelton wheel turbine will be called or comes under the category of your hydraulic turbines. And this Kaplan turbine, you can see this animation how the fluid will be entering. Fluid will be in comes center and it will be enters towards your angle of your guide blade. And again, it will be flowed towards your propeller, and that will make your propeller to rotate. And further, here also you will be having a draft tube, and you know the draft tube is just minimize the exit pressure so that it will not affect your outlet area. Actually, steam turbines I just excluded because of your time consumption will be more. I thought so. So I just extruded your steam turbine.
Thanks for watching. Please share with your friends. Stay safe, stay home. Take care. Bye.